So I call this meditation wandering over a question, because we're going to do some simple walking meditation and use that as a focal point for our attention. And that will serve as an anchor so that we can invite in the kind of analytical, convergent type thinking that's really helpful to solve a specific creative problem. So we're just going to begin by tuning into the present. You can take a few deep breaths, try to just relax into a comfortable posture with your body nice and straight. And now I'm simply going to begin walking at sort of a slow, normal pace, because I'm using a limited space. And I'm going to bring my attention to the sensations in the soles of my feet, where they're making contact with the ground. I'm just going to notice what those sensations are like. You can try focusing on one leg only for a bit, and then shift over to the other for a pace. And to explore different paces a little bit more, now I'm going to speed up. I'm just going to notice what that does to the sensations. I already noticed that the sensations are more focused into certain parts of my feet, and they're also more fleeting. And now I'm going to slow right down, as if I'm trying to sneak up on someone. For some reason, this makes me want to crouch a little bit, but you can sneak more upright. Or just walk this slowly more upright. You may notice that it's a bit different for keeping your balance, because we're so used to opposing this motion. So it can help to actually do that slowly and strangely. And now, for the purposes of this meditation, what I'm going to be doing is a slow step pace, where before the back leg lifts off, I wait until the weight is completely on this leg. So I kind of like to get a little bit of a roll going from one foot to the next, like that. And during this practice, I'm going to bring up my question. The creative problem I'm trying to solve. Maybe you don't have it as a question, maybe you just feel creatively stuck right now. And you can make that question, why am I creatively stuck? And wander over that for this practice. And if you have something more specific, you can bring that to mind right now. So what we're going to do is just ask the question and then wander on. We're using these sensations in the feet, again, as an anchor. So you may find that as you ponder your question, it may lead to more questions. I'm pondering my journal prompt today, which is simply, what is your favorite song or poem about springtime, and how does that make you feel? So that definitely leads to some other questions for me, like, what are songs about springtime I know? How do I feel about springtime? And if any sort of thought or extra question comes up that captures you, you can actually stop and just allow yourself to ponder it for a little bit before wandering on. Thank you. If any other thoughts come up, though, I definitely want you to stop. And if you can, put a label on it. Like, let's say I just thought, oh, I should get milk later. I'm going to label that plan and let it move on. And once I'm ready for it to move on, I can move on. But we want to keep our wandering focused on the sensations in the feet. And what we're really trying to invite for any other thoughts are thoughts related to our question, our problem. So anything else that comes up, if I get a, did I leave the stove on? I'm going to call that worry and I'm going to let it go away. I got off my roll there while I was thinking about my question, and that might happen. So I'm just going to reestablish the roll. And then we'll just, instead of returning to what I was thinking about the question, just focus on this for a bit. And if any thoughts about my question come up, I'll let them return in their own time. The nature of my question actually leads to a lot of distracting thoughts, because I find in my own practice, one of the hardest thoughts to let go of often will be something about a song. If I get a song in my head, it can be really hard to let go. Anyone who's ever had an earworm stuck in their head knows exactly what I'm talking about. And so thinking about this question, I'm certainly getting certain songs coming in to capture my attention. So one technique I've found useful for songs in particular is to kind of fake a Doppler effect in my head. So this is the effect when a car is coming by. If it's playing music, you'll hear it get louder and then recede. And for whatever reason, that helps me let the song move on by literally thinking of it as something that's in a moving vehicle. So I'll let the song get louder and then let the volume decrease to help it move on, which is especially helpful for this, because what I'm trying to think of right now are several different songs and I don't want to get stuck on one. So I'll reestablish my role, focusing on the sounds in your environment can also be a good way of letting a song thought move on. Can also be helpful if you find yourself getting a lot of distracting thoughts and you stopping a lot to have it, to let them move on, to focus again, like I said before, on just one foot as it presses and then lifts, presses and then lifts, and then switch to the other whenever you feel ready for that. So this is the basic process of this wandering meditation. Simply use these feet sensations as an anchor. Stop whenever you have a distracting thought that you want to let move on. And just allow yourself maybe to return to that question periodically if it gets a little too, if you wander a little too far away from it. And you can keep practicing this in an indoor space like this, or you can always take it for a walk outside in the park if you feel like. Just if you do, it helps to go somewhere you're familiar with so that you can have a sort of predetermined path to go on. Going for a walk to solve an issue has long been touted by writers and many creatives, and myself, I've found it a really great way to get a lot of thoughts kind of just free flowing. But if you can also focus on your feet sensations as you walk, again, you're providing yourself an anchor for your attention to return to so that it doesn't wander off too far. So feel free to continue this for as long as you like.
Thank you. Remember that the only bad practice is the one you didn't do. So take a moment to feel some gratitude for the chance to practice today and for the efforts you put into it. Until next time.